time I'd like to call the regular meeting to order. At this time, we will stand and say the pledge of allegiance. And also, before we get started, we also remember the death of Nancy Reagan. She was a great statesman, and let's just honor her life at this time.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Oh, we live as a purpose.
Absolutely. Let's bow our heads in prayer, please. Our Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you for another beautiful day, and you know we deserve it. Lord, we ask that you'll be with this meeting tonight, that you'll guide it, that you'll watch over these elected officials, that you'll give them the courage to make the decisions, give them the ability to see the decisions that are in the best interest of the locality. Lord, we ask that you'll guide us all as we leave here this evening. Lead us into another tomorrow. We ask all of this in your Son's name. Amen.
Amen.
At this time, we have two changes on the agenda. One is the first one, Tazewell One Act Play. They won't be here tonight. Many of those members are practicing soccer or other activities, and hopefully we get them some other time. We've been trying to do this for 3 months, and they actually finished second in the state. We'd like to honor them at this time. Also, as I noted in the public hearing, we will not be voting on vacation of the alley of 3rd Street and Mitchell Street at this time. At this time, I'd like to do a resolution. It's a great honor to be able to acknowledge our youth. And these youths, with the academic team here tonight, is our leaders in the future. I expect when they get about 25 years from now, one of these guys will be running for president, running the right way. Dignified, publicified, and diplomatically. Okay, at this time, we'll ask Mr. McAvoy if you'll introduce your team, and I'll read this resolution. We'll ask them to come forward.
Here tonight, we don't have the full team, but we have one of our two juniors, Griffin McAvoy, who's been our leading scorer all year. We have all three of our sophomores, John Brown, who's our literature specialist. All right, John. David Calfee, who helps us with math.
Y'all come on up.
And Elias Tyson, who is our history and religion man. We have three of our four freshmen, Freddie Smith.
This resolution.
Mr. McAvoy, all right.
Whereas the Tazewell High School academic team finished the regular season undefeated with 14 victories against 7 different opponents, including 2 victories over 2015-2016 state championship. And whereas the Tazewell High School academic team earned the Southern Empire Conference 39 championship to at Southwest Virginia Community College on January 30th, 2016. And whereas the Tazewell High School academic team won Region 2A West Runner-Up Trophy at the Southwest Virginia Community College on February the 6th. Whereas the Tazewell High School academic team placed 4th in the Virginia High School Lake Scholastic Bowl Championship at the College of William & Mary on February 27th. Whereas at the Tazewell High School All Academic Team led by Coach Tom McElroy and Captain Aaron Christian, comprised of Griffin McElroy, Garrett Nunley, John Brown, David Calford, Elisha Tyson, Haley Hatfield, Daniel Lafferty, Freddie Smith, and Gabby Taylor, displayed academic excellence and sportsmanship in the competition in the fields of English, mathematics, science, social studies, and miscellaneous categories, including current events, entertainment, and arts and science. Therefore, be it resolved that I, Don Buchanan, Mayor of the Town of Tazewell, and the citizen, with the citizens concurrent, do hereby command and congratulate the Tazewell High School academic team for a job well done. Best wishes and continued success and futures. Let me get the bill back. You want to take another picture, John?
Sir? Yeah.
Thank you, brother.
Will be color-coded to match your space on the board and can include your logo and description of your business. This purchase will ensure advertising through visual exposure of your business for years to come. Every time a family plays Tazewell Opry, they will be reminded of all the different and unique businesses that serve Tazewell every day. Also included on the board will be landmarks and events such as the Cruise Inn and Main Street Moments that have brought families together and created lasting memories. These deeds are on sale now during the design process. Being included as a Tazewell business owner will not only make you part of history through the Tazewell Opry, but will claim a space of advertising that will last for generations. Those interested should contact the Treasury office here at Town Hall by March the 31st for more details. The game should be on sale to the public in the fall, just in time for that special Christmas gift. Thank you.
Okay.
All right.
Okay, thank you, Sharon. Next on the agenda is audit report from Justin Martin, Ground Neighbors.
While he's working his way up to the front, I emailed out to council about a week ago the audit, and you've got it right here in front of your hard copy also.
Good evening. I'm Justin Martin with Ground Edwards. I'm in charge of the town's audit. Tonight I'd like to present the audit in accordance with state code, but first I'd like to thank Sharon and Todd for all their hard work and their assistance in completing audit this year, especially Sharon. Her first time through the ringer here, and she definitely helped us out a ton. Ultimately, the town received a clean opinion. In the report, it's noted as an unmodified opinion. This is the highest level of assurance that we can provide the town.
Oh, you can stop right there.
The main thing, when you look through, there were two significant changes from the previous year. One would be other post-employment benefits. That would be the retirees' health insurance. In adopting that and implementing that, that created a liability on the financial statements that was different from the prior year. Also, in 2015, there were new pension reporting requirements. And with that, that created actually an asset on the books, which kind of helped offset some of the liability with the other post-employment benefit. Both of these are reporting requirements, really not change in operation. There were also two other communications that we included. One would be the letter on internal controls. This kind of summarizes some of our suggestions and recommendations on ways the town can strengthen controls. Over the past couple of years, there have been definitely increases in that. We've seen good changes. And in talking with Sharon, they have some good ideas on how to further mitigate those. Also included is the governance letter. This summarizes our some of our adjustments and some of the other required reporting with y'all. Those are kind of the main changes from the prior year. Everything else seemed pretty standard. Do y'all have any questions?
Does anyone got any questions for me? Yeah, I'm sure it was trying a little bit for Sharon and being sort of halfway through the fiscal year because she started basically.
She was in here for 3 months of this audit period, so you'll find that we will continue to strengthen areas of where we're short at. And we do have a book. We should go over that, and we will address all areas and respond to all areas of deficiency if they exist. Probably.
I can see you think major. I look at a lot. It's a lot. So, does anyone else have any questions for me?
If y'all think of anything, feel free to reach out.
Okay, we will.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Justin.
This time we have other comments. Anyone wishing to speak, please sign in. And again, the regular meeting, please state your name and address and limit your presentation to 3 minutes. Tammy Smith.
Tammy Smith, 103 East Riverside Drive. You all know that we've been coming with several, improvements that we would like to see, in the area. And I made a phone call today to Kim Santala, and she want to help in our efforts to do some things by donating some plants to the North Tazewell area, and hopefully then our committee can take responsibility, everybody go out and water the plants and that kind of thing. But I was just wondering, you know, if you guys, you know anybody that can help with any of these efforts, the things that we're trying to do, that get outreach. We're going to do a community pickup day. We're going to pick up litter from one side of, and Todd said he would help us, you know, with bags and things, you know, that we would need from one end to the other. The one thing, and DeWitt and I hit a little bit on this, you know, we're going to have to get on the litter, you know. Something really, really needs to be done. I can get a garbage bag a week of litter, and, you know, once people litter and it blows. But this is a positive step, and I really appreciate him and her greenhouse, you know, doing this to help the area. But any of you all, you know, if you know anybody that has something that can help with the, you know, improvements, just to notify our project, okay? All right, thank you.
I might get my dad out there to let him oversee something. I mean,
you're a child.
Next on the agenda is Claudine Blankenship.
Good evening, gentlemen. Thank you for allowing me to speak to you this evening. First of all, before I begin, I'd like to thank all of you for your the time that you spend in working very hard and for our community and our town. I know that when you were elected, you took on a very large job, and I sincerely appreciate all of the time that you spend in helping our town to be a better place. And I feel like that is happening. We are turning a corner, I think, at Tazewell, and I think that is thanks to you and a lot of other people. So I want to thank you very much. I'm here tonight on behalf of the Tazewell Chamber of Commerce, and there is an event that we are wanting to do, and we're seeking your blessing to present this event to our town. And it is called Blues, Cued, and Brew. It is a barbecue festival, a blues festival, and a brews festival all combined into one. This is something that the Chamber has talked in depth about, and we've worked with John Gunner, with the ABC board, and they regulate that very strictly, what can happen with the alcohol and the amount of alcohol that is served. And, so we would like to ask you if you would graciously support our festival.
When do you have this planned?
Excuse me?
When do you have this planned?
We don't have a defined date yet. We had first thought we would do it Labor Day, and then the farm to table, which is something I'd like to speak with you about as well after I finish with this. The farm to table event is going to be on August the 27th. And so that would be back to back events. So we're going to look at possibly October for this event.
I think it's a good idea. I mean, to turn something around in town of Tazewell, it's great. I like to see all around. And I think Todd's doing a great job of what he's doing.
Yes, we do too.
I'm all for it because we got to move somewhere. We can't be sitting here just watching and waiting. We got to make that move and go with it.
Thank you. I would like to mention to you something that we'll be presenting a little later. We, as in not in the chamber, because the other event that I'm going to mention to you, that I just want to mention it tonight to make you aware that a planning committee has been developed for an event called Farm to Table. And it is an event that is going to be working directly with the farmers who are working with the farmers market. And we'll be preparing a meal, and tables will be set along the middle of Main Street. And a meal will be prepared and served through the local restaurants, i.e. churches, other organizations, using the food that has been grown by our local farmers. So it's to help promote farmers market and the farm products that are being developed. So I will be approaching you later on with more information on this, But I just wanted to make you aware that that event is being developed and planned as well.
I think these are both wonderful ideas, and we all appreciate the work you're doing as well to find new ways of getting people into our town. So thank you.
I would agree. We applaud your efforts and wholeheartedly offer our support.
In fact, I'd like to, so they can get moving on this, Mayor, I'd like to put a motion on the floor that we approve the Blues Q. Is it Q or barbecue? Blues Q and
Brews.
Yes. So they can get moving on this, and they don't have to wait another month to start nailing this thing down. So I'd like to put a motion on the table that we approve this festival so that they can get moving on it and get going on Main Street the way it needs to be done. I'll say.
I'd like to see that happen.
Okay, got a motion and I have a second.
I like the motion on that.
Yeah, we've already got a motion.
It's already seconded?
Okay.
Good enough over there.
All right. Any other discussion, please?
I just want to say thank you.
Okay.
Thank you, Ms. Smith.
Okay. Any other discussion? Hearing none, call for a vote. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Thank you.
Thank you all very much.
Thank you all very much.
Next on the agenda is the approval of the minutes. Do I have a motion to approve the minutes of February 9th, 2016?
I make that motion.
I have a motion. Do I have a second?
Second.
Any additions or corrections? Hearing none, call for a vote. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carried. Next is the approval of the work session on February 23rd. Minutes. Do I have a motion to that effect?
I so moved.
Do I have a second?
Second.
Any discussion or corrections? Not hearing none, call for a vote. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carried. Next is the approval of the financial statements on February 2006 as presented. Do I have a motion to that effect?
So moved.
Second.
Any additions or corrections? Hearing none, call for a vote. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Next on agenda is presentation of project and activities report. I have a motion to accept those as presented.
So moved.
Second.
Any additions or corrections? Or questions? If not, call for a vote. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carried. Next on agenda is town manager's update on ongoing projects. Mr. Day.
Okay, Route 61, as you can see, if you've driven up 61 between Lincolnshire and 460 corridor, it is well underway. It's a 580-day project. We're about a month into it. Look forward to a successful completion. The results of that will be when you pull out of the shopping center that's where Pizza Hut is, the view, you will no longer have to punch a gas pedal or hit the brake when it's done. There'll also be two commercial entrances, one put into the Lester development, one put into the Barnes development, just on right of way. We're not going into personal property, but it'll just help secure future potential for economic development. The Lincolnshire Dam, no changes. Route 61 bridge, no changes. The water meter replacement program, I think we've got right at about 500 more meters to go out of. Is that right, Don?
We got, as of today, we'll have about 1,700 in.
1,700 in, we got about 24, we got 22.
Five something.
Yeah, we got about 5 something. So it's going really well. We had 1 or 2 days last week that they were in the 90 meters a day. And if you do the math on that 8 hours, that's pretty aggressive. So today, yesterday they were in the 70s, but they're moving on pretty good. Good project, and the return on investment will absolutely benefit the citizens and the community. North Tazewell update, I did have the opportunity and the pleasure to be invited and attend a meeting in North Tazewell last week. A lot of wonderful ideas, especially with respect to the water meters. A lot of great suggestions come out of it. And two of them that I can think of right off the bat, we are going to put it on the water bills, which was a recommendation from North Tazewell, I think was wonderful. And in order to eliminate the last minute hoopla of people coming out We are also going to start tomorrow and go door to door with everybody that's going to be impacted by the PSI increase. And all we're going to do is put a pamphlet in the door. And so I think between the newsletter, we mailed that letter out also, going door to door, and the activities here in the publicity that may come out of the council meeting, that video right there that can be seen 24/7 on the website. I think we've maximized our ability to communicate. I also talked to Doug Sheets. Doug Sheets, if you'll recall, council came to a meeting sometime back about Dry Town and offer assistance. He forwarded or CC'd me on an email he sent to corporate today. So I'm waiting to hear back a response from Queens Valley on the possibility of assisting some of the individuals that may be at lower income. So very positive meeting. The police department was very much involved in some of the things that DeWitt's going to do to improve the presence of the police department. I think the meeting overall was another success. I look forward to the future outcome and working with more Tazewell. And as Tammy mentioned, they will be picking a day. We'll take the garbage truck, we'll take manpower. Obviously, our manpower cannot go on the personal property, but if they'll bring it to the right of way, we'll throw it in the truck. We will work hand in hand with them to clean up the neighborhood. And I would encourage you, any area in town, not just North Tazewell, any area in town, if you want to have a cleanup day, we absolutely encourage you. We'll give you free bags, hard hats, gloves, shiny vests so people can see you, but it's nothing but positive. So I really look forward to your future as North Tazewell makes it.
Also, Todd, the project offered, if it does fall through with Clinch Valley, somehow to try to be able to do that for people. So you don't have people in screaming in your office, that somehow we can do that to have that in place for the elderly and people.
Sure.
Yeah.
Yeah. Very positive.
Yeah, that's true.
And there's one other update I'm going to let Todd alleviate on, and it's their illustrious potholes on Main Street.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, and as everybody knows, I was really proud of that asphalt last year. That was actually free money. They had federal funds in it, but it was free. We had the opportunity to pay Main Street. And I was tickled to death walking around my head all high, did something real good, and next thing you know, it looked like an atom bomb hit up through there. Rogers Group will be coming back in the next couple of weeks to at least mill, and then they will be repaving, and it's at no charge to the locality, the taxpayers. They'll be doing 100% turnkey job, including the thermal striping. So, and they're also looking at the street over here at the high school, also we're having problems with. So it happens. I saw VDOT mill up 3 miles on 81 of asphalt. It wasn't 2 weeks old because of, you know, some informalities, technical informalities. So it's not uncommon for it to happen. It does in every profession. I just hated that they had to have more Main Street than that. But it is going to be addressed, and I appreciate everybody's patience and hope you don't wear any ball bearings out front end and dodge a block.
Everybody, I understand it's almost like a drag strip up to where you can see the dust fly all over the place. But they know what the potholes are because they're going right or left.
And you got to, you know, there's some hangups on Main Street, you know, with the construction of businesses. And if you're going to have hang-ups, I'd rather pay for construction than working on blooming potholes or water leaks after we pave the street. But, you know, the alleyway between here and Main Street was shut off today. Mike Hines, that building is beginning to really cosmetically come to life. Nancy Brooks has got a lot going on. Irma. There's several businesses under construction on Main Street, and I'm tickled to death to have those construction hang-ups when it comes to traveling. So the more of those I have, the happier I am. But when it comes to potholes, I'm not very sick of them.
I want to add something to Todd's updates. It makes me, one thing I think makes me proud of Tazewell is the citizens start to step up to do something. You know, I've actually said in the two meetings I had attend at North Tassel's meeting, and they're caring about their community, and also Tassel today, met with them the week before, and with the train station committee. And everybody's excited about doing something in the chamber, and we're the envy of the county, we really are. And they want to know how we are turning it around, but the reason we're turning it around is because of the citizens of downtown Tassel. It's not because we make decisions up here, it's because everybody's scared.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Tom? Well, we're talking about North Tassel over there. You and I talked about this briefly, but I would like to see the town paint our building over there.
Okay, that's easy.
It's right across from the Cardinal, they were walling out.
Right.
Where we put all those cinder blocks and stuff in there, and all that patchwork on the building. I think if we paint that whole building, it would look so much better than.
You're going to go just part of the building because it's the town on the entire building.
Well, I said our building.
We can do that.
Yeah, I think it would help. And then I don't see why we couldn't contact the owners of those other buildings and ask them if they might not be able to do a little.
We can do that too. I know that there's several entrepreneurs that are very, one of them actually in this room, but I'm not going to say who I respect to, but there's several entrepreneurs in the community that are looking at two of those buildings to purchase as we speak. So there's some exciting things all around happening over there. The bowling alley went to closing last week. We had one small complication, and Brad's already addressed that. Hopefully, next meeting I come to, we will own that bowling alley, and the IDA will have obviously the title and the deed to that bowling alley lot, and we'll tear it down next fiscal year. A lot of good things going on. We can absolutely get the paint coming 5 gallon buckets.
Can I all be painted through there?
Can you want
to? We can't paint them.
No, the others, yeah.
Well, that's up to them.
Well, you work with one of them, so you get him to paint his.
I guess I'll have to talk to him.
Nothing wrong with the town going to them and asking if they can't automatically fix it up so that it would look a lot better.
I agree. We can do that.
Okay.
You're going to be spending a lot of money over there on that train station to have that eyesore sitting up there.
Good idea. Great idea.
Yeah, Todd, before we leave the North Tazewell, if you could just give us an update with the recycling.
Yes, and I hate to drag it out, but I'm going to tell you the way it's going. Every week since we last met, there's been one email that's went out from me, and at least two in the last month from Brad. I can assure you and show you we're doing everything we can on our side to get access to Mr. Lester. The hang-up right now is Mr. Lester is very much guarded by his property manager, Jim Farrell. And I'm not saying that's right or wrong, but we do have a communication line we have to go through. We're absolutely on it. We've got drawings of it, of the site, and we're doing everything we can do to get there. And I apologize for the hang-up, but we're pushing. We'll keep pushing.
All right. Okay. Moving on, committee and conference updates. Planning Commission, Councilman Murray.
Planning Commission met again last night. We had a public hearing on the new comprehensive plan. And after the hearing, we voted on it, we approved it. We have now brought it to the town council. We did discuss some other things, which right now, I think we're gonna talk about one of them a little later on tonight.
Next time is the Train Depot Committee.
I'm sorry, Mayor.
Okay.
Train Station Committee has, I don't believe we've met since the last council meeting, but we are meeting a week from tonight, which is the Ides of March. That's why we said things. We're back in Remember Hope. It's March 15th at 6:30 at the Historical Society. Mr. Rates is going to be there, our architect, talk to us. So I hope everybody who's on the Train Station Committee or anybody else who's interested and would like to be there, we welcome you at 6:30 at the Historical Society Tuesday. The restoration is, I understand, underway as we speak. And I believe, Mr. Day, we're on schedule at this point.
We are way ahead of schedule. We are actually at the first VDOT form of submittal, which is 30%.
So it's looking good. The two-year plan is
so far on target,
being worked as we speak.
Yeah, I challenged Terry several years ago on that. I think he's going to meet that goal. Okay, next on the agenda is the Airport Authority. Councilman McReynolds, do you have any additional things to?
Yeah, this year has been a very slow start. One, mainly to the weather, and two, economy, coal related. We can all understand that. Most of my traffic involves people with coal, so that's something we're real concerned about. We do have the West End Drainage Project. It's been going on for a year. It was a 70-day project. We still got some problems there. There is some legal stuff going on now between the county and the contractor, and we're hoping to get that resolved here shortly. We're supposed to fire back up this month and complete that project. But with this legal stuff going on, I'm not sure that we'll get it completed or not. We have a huge project ongoing for obstruction removals, which is on and off the airport, both ends, which involves a safety flight path for people using using the airport, mainly with jets. And that'll probably take not only this year, probably even into next year. It involves property, private and airport property both. And we also are looking very much forward to our flying and air show in August, and it'll involve a car show, a motorcycle show, and airplanes. So we're looking forward to that and want to invite everybody down. And if you want to learn how to fly, I've got a great flight instructor.
Next is our 150th anniversary. Susan Moose.
Our committee has been hard at work planning a full year of events. I have an outline here. We also have a keepsake ornament that we will be selling. So we have a preview of that to pass around as well. That we have. On our events, we'll be participating in the Easter egg hunt. We'll have special eggs that we will be including in the Easter egg hunt. And each of those eggs, when the eggs are found, they can win, we decided a Monopoly board, t-shirts if we have those available at that time. We also have a Main Street Mile community walk planned. We have the Sesquicentennial Ball, and we made a slight change to that. We had originally discussed having that at Crabtree Museum, and now we've decided to have it on Main Street to set up the tables and have the music and everything there. We are in the process of planning the Independence Day celebration. We have extra events to be included as part of that day as well. We'll have a Sesquicentennial Parade that will help kick off Main Street Moments. It will be the Friday that they have the music at THS. So we'll be having the parade and finishing up there. We will also have haunted ghost tours of Main Street in the fall. And then various activities throughout the year that we will just be participating in. The Tazewell County Fair, we'll have a booth set up there. Back of the Dragon, we're in talks with them to see how we can bring the Sesquicentennial into that celebration as well. So just a full year of events.
All right.
This is great. Thank you.
Yeah, it's great. Y'all have done a great job in getting this organized, and hopefully everything will be weather permitting. Great. And also on that. There's a resolution before the General Assembly, and I looked the other day to see where that was at, and actually it was on the Speaker of the House desk, and I guess they wait to do all the resolutions at the end, so I'm not sure exactly how that's gone through, and whenever the Assembly is finished, hopefully they'll have a resolution. by the Challenge Assembly Honor of Town Tazewell. Thank you, Susan. Okay, next on the agenda is unfinished business. Is the water audit?
Yes, as each council member knows, we do have an agreement with the PSA. They own the plant. We buy every drop of water out of it. And, the way we do that is we come up with an educated calculation that is as surgical as we can get it to estimate the cost of water. And we go throughout the fiscal year at that cost per gallon, which is ran around right at $1.13 per thousand. And then we do an audit at the end of the year, and if it's more, we play catch up, or if it's less, they pay us. But I'll go through this very briefly. And right now, Sharon is still working with Brown Edwards to do the sewer side, which is a mirror image of this. So hopefully, in the next couple of months, we'll be able to bring the sewer audit. But if you'll open your exhibit that you have in front of you on page three, the bottom on the right side of page three, you have the plant audit, the cost of running the treatment plant, which includes labor, chemical material, and power, including Robinson Farmer and Cox's price of the audit itself is $1,500. That's using a dividend of 500 million gallons. And by the way, it's in this book right here. I apologize if you, each of you have the white book. But that totals 99 cents a thousand, and then they do the calculation on the administrative side, which is in the middle where it says annual administrative expense, and it's broke down the employees in the office, etc. And that is an additional 12 cents. You add them together, then at the bottom right-hand corner, it comes to 1.127, and it's carried out a couple of digits. If you'll turn the page to page four, it's not numbered, it says Exhibit 2 at the upper right-hand corner. You can see that the calculation that we paid in July of 2014, which is in the first column, we paid 1.133, which was based on last fiscal year's audit. So we just moved forward, and those costs are tabulated on the right hand side of the first block where it says total. If you go over to the right hand column, you can see that they used the audited number, which by the way went down to 1.123, which is 300, so it's not a whole lot. But to make a long story short, if you flip over to Exhibit 3, the bottom line is that for the first time in 4 years that I've been here, they owe us $3,000. So that's pretty accurate, and it's a guessing game. It's an educated guessing game. Next year we may owe them, they may owe us. So when you look at 500 million gallons of water that went through that plant, we're $3,000 off in a whole fiscal year. So that's not bad. We have in the budget, if you'll recall, right at $30,000 budgeted in expense in the water fund to cover the potential true-up. And we won't be using that line item. If they do an upgrade to that plant, you will use that line item. But if we do one at the sewer plant, which is a mirror image of this contract. So hopefully in the next couple of months, we'll have the sewer plant audit ready for you to review also. Any questions?
Okay, do I hear a motion to approve the water audit?
Second.
Any other discussion? You're not called for a vote. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Also, approve the water true up. Same time. Mm-hmm. For motion to that effect.
So moved.
Second. Any other discussion?
You need to add a figure for the record to that, Mayor.
Okay, $3,862.22.
Back to the table.
Okay.
I made my motion to reflect that.
You
second it.
Any other discussion?
Yeah.
Hearing none, call for vote. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carried. Thank you. Update on bowling alley.
As Todd mentioned earlier, we've got everything pretty much in line with the bowling alley property transfer. Had a slight hiccup in the title due to an SEC requirement for the current owner. So we're basically in touch with the administrative folks up in Richmond on that. Hope we have that back. Hopefully within the next 30 days. Can't make any guarantees because it's once we send the information to them, it will depend upon their timetable before we get it back. And once it is back in play, then I'll be back in touch with Mr. Allen, who will then be, he's already ready to go in terms of making the donation to the town. It's just a matter of getting that information from the State Corporation Commission. That's it.
Now, the gentleman that's in there now has 1 year, is that right?
March 1st, next year. So, yes. He has until February 28th, he is 17. And that's by the agreement that the town has with Mr. Allen. Mr. Allen,
yeah, you got that. That's
correct. Yes.
And we will work with him. But it may not include the under roof real estate. I don't know that he's even using it, period. So he may say go ahead and move forward with it, but it'll still be next fiscal year.
Evidently, I think he is because I noticed that the end down there, there's a garage door there, and it's when they're there, it's open. So
that's probably using the active facilities. Might be the most to keep. Okay. Next on the agenda is new business. It's the ABC license discussion for the Mountain Motor.
Okay, if you'll recall, last year the Mountain Motor was held at the fairgrounds. Of course, that's a law to the county. This year, I'm pleased to announce that the Mountain Motor will be in our political jurisdiction at Lincolnshire. Past the mountain terrain was very attractive to charity. There was an entity last year, Chris helped me out, it was Tazewell that did the beer license.
It was Brian.
Okay, well they're asking council's permission to do that again this year, just as the request you had earlier, long story short. And she's got a letter in here, I'm sure each of you have had a chance to look at it. But it's to do the same thing, the same guidelines. It's a two drink max, and it'll be held at Lincolnshire. Council voted last month to lock that date up and reserve the entire park for the Mountain Motor. So that request, and I need a, obviously a majority vote on the statement.
I'll make that motion.
Got a motion, do I have a second?
Second.
Any discussion? I do have one question, not necessarily, basically on the date. I know typically the swim team final event somewhere at the end of July.
Right.
Do you know whether they are actually having it here or somewhere else?
We have communicated, Tracy has communicated with all the organizations, okay, and groups, and we will work around that event. I'm not so sure it's scheduled. I don't think it's scheduled on that day. I'm pretty certain.
Okay. Well, sometimes they don't have it. In Tazewell, they have
actually, the association meet is in Tazewell this year.
Okay.
Yes, it is in Tazewell. They meet is. I'm up to date while I'm not for sure.
Wait, so when you say you closed down Lincolnshire, would you have to close that part?
We're just closing down 100%. Yes. 100%. But she wants the entire park to use for obviously obstacles and whatnot. And by the way, that's the organization is Lean Tazewell, and it's headed by Ms. Beck.
Yeah, it's that's the organization.
And the ABC license.
What's the date?
What is the date of the motor?
Is it the 30th?
I'd like to say one thing. I sit here tonight, I've sat on this council for over 5 years. I've sat here tonight and I'm hearing two different organizations coming before town. We're going to be selling beer.
Actually, it's the same organization. Chamber doesn't have
money. The same organization then wants to sell beer two times, one on Main Street, one down at Fairgrounds.
Yes.
I'm not in favor of the beer thing, but I'll go along with it. I don't want to impede it. But I just think it's a shame that we all of a sudden we've got to go to something like that to where we can start
getting, and I use your words, Ms. Blankenship, the young people involved and alcohol play is not the way to get young people involved. But it's, I hope we're not starting precedents here that we're more and more and more.
I will say this much to address that, Councilmember. There are a number of events, particularly running events that I participate in. You're seeing these type of events. I think Tazewell's at the tail end of the curve as opposed to being, trying to do something that's completely novel and maybe something that could be on the front end of being maybe questionable. You're seeing a lot of successful events in Roanoke, Greensboro, Charlotte, that do a lot for the local economy and are run safely and efficiently, and I really think it's one that it will be something you'll be, the whole council will back and be proud of. I really believe that.
Well, I think, as I said, it's just, I don't doubt that it's successful and I don't doubt that it will help, but it's just something that, this is my personal opinion. I'm not an alcohol person. I'm not in favor of alcohol. And I don't like the idea of selling beer on Main Street where our churches and stuff are.
And I do, for one, admire it in respect to comments, and I think the communication with the churches, that they'll absolutely address those areas. And when it comes to the safety of the community, once again, I fully understand, but Dean Witt being on the chamber, we will do everything that we can to assure that the community, is the event's handled safe and that it is well managed. So, but I do fully understand your comments, and there are a lot of people in this room that probably agree with you too. So well said, and we will do everything we can to make it a successful event.
And if I could echo kind of what Brad said, I used to run quite a bit too, and none of these events, it's not a party when you get finished. It's usually after, you expend a lot of energy and it's a carb load, so to speak. After, it's, you have one or two beers and it's not like people are, rolling on the ground or anything.
I didn't think it would be that. I know it's controlled and everything.
Right.
But as I said, I just think it's a shame when we have to start going to something like that to get the young people involved in something. Because
remember, these young people are Brad's age and Dr. Kathy.
Thank you, Dr.
I'll just say one thing. That ain't young.
That's what the point is.
Okay, we have a motion and a statement. Any other discussion?
The possibility of a conflict with the swim association meeting's not there then?
Not that I know of, but I will absolutely repair it if it is. I'll assure you that event, that swim meet, will be held here. I'm pretty confident that we looked at that and we worked for that. I can tell you that Tracy keeps up with that very thoroughly and we struggle for that day. So I will assure you that event will not be hampered. It'll go forward.
And I guess that's actually first day of the fair too, so. Okay, call for a vote. All in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Motion. Any nays? Hear none? Call for a vote. Motion carried. All right. Next is the donation to the request from Southwest Virginia Community College.
Okay, I've got a bunch of donation requests. Typically, I bring those to y'all in the budget work session. This one has got a time deadline on it. Last year, we did make a donation of $500. It's an annual thing that we've done for Southwest Virginia Community College. I just need to know how council wants to proceed for this upcoming year.
I believe they're going to have one of those things here in town at some churches. Yes, so I make a motion that we give him $500. You got a motion, you got a second?
Second.
Any other discussion? Hearing none, call for a vote. All in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Motion carried. It's on the agenda of the section 10 of 54B.
Okay, a number of years ago, prior to any department heads you have now, there was a motion supposedly made to reduce a discount for cigarette tax. And we unfortunately never made it to the code book. We have not been recognizing that discount, and we need to repair it officially. I need to vote to repair it. And it was a point, it was 6/100ths of a discount for cigarette tax. I just need a motion to remove it. And for Brad to make the necessary changes to put in the code book.
I'll make that motion.
And I'll second.
Any other discussion? We need the exact wording or not, it's just as...
It would basically be a repeal of section 10-54B in terms of the amount.
And that'd be a repeal of that section with the amount of the discount. Any other discussion? If you're not calling for a vote, all favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carried. Next on the agenda is the Deer Run Lane discussion.
I think the council may be aware, of course, in your package you've got a photograph there of the subdivision, or at least a portion of it that's off of Dogwood Road, Deer Run Lane. Several years ago, when that property was subdivided, there was unfortunately several problems that were not taken care of relative to the actual dedication. The one parcel you see there, it's actually listed as tax map number 94B608-12A. And it looks like a very long rectangular piece that's actually surrounds existing that Deer Run Lane that's through there. It needs to be actually dedicated to the town and taken into the town's right-of-way system. The owner has agreed to do that. We're in the process of getting basically the deed and language together for that dedication of that piece of property to allow for that property to be donated to the town. Taken into the towns, they are dedicated, I should say not donated, but dedicated to the town for the purposes of making Deer Run Lane a fully dedicated right-of-way within the town's street system. And we hope to have that done by the next council meeting. It'll be something that Todd will need to take in and actually sign off as an acceptance by the council that you are taking into the town, because by code, no one can just arbitrarily say, I'm going to give this piece of property to town, I don't want to fool with it anymore. It has to be accepted by the town, fully acknowledged by the council, and then approved by me as the town attorney. It's something I think it's definitely that needs to be done. It's one that the council will vote to approve that, then they can, you can authorize the manager to sign off on the deed accepting that into the town system.
I'll make that motion.
Second.
Any motion and second. Any other discussion? Not here. Call for a vote. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carried. Next on agenda is clean up the pump. In the past, we have selected May as a cleanup month, and we had a multitude of people who would like us to move that forward a little bit until April, and instead of just all May, and I would like to designate April 15th through May 15th as cleanup month. Is that fine, Tom?
You know, I think that we'll make it work. The biggest thing about April is the birds are beginning and everything's waking up, and we are strong, but we will absolutely give it a go, see how it goes this year. If not, we'll move back to that.
Did you just say birds?
Yeah, birds. We are birds. You know, you're out of the way.
I just want to make sure I heard that. So we can't get this done, it's because of the birds.
You know, in the wintertime, it looks like everybody's in a dormant sleep. All of a sudden, everybody just wakes up in the spring. And, you know, we're overwhelmed.
John, did you get that video from
God, I wish that. Okay.
I'll make that motion.
You have a second?
Second.
Any other discussion? All right, we say
aye.
Next thing is the fire department, Billy.
Okay, I recently discovered that in 2013, our General Assembly passed legislation that allowed fire departments to bid for fire cops. And what we're looking to do under state charter is to bill for fire calls for deductible only. We're not going to go to a fire, and if they don't have insurance, chase the individuals, deductible only. But I have included in your packet the legislation. I've also included in your packet where it says that any insurance provider in the Commonwealth must provide homeowners that insurance to support the legislation. So it is a state supported. I've talked to Josh. Josh has reviewed it and he fully supports it. And I'll quote, as long as we do not go after the uninsured portion, we're just looking for the fair, right deductible that every homeowner pays on fire calls. And it's not going to be a cash cow by any means. We run how many calls?
130, but if you just build fires, it's far less than that.
Yeah, it's so, you know, it's not significant, but it will help. And once again, it is supported by the state of Virginia due to legislation it passed in 2013. And I've got a couple of documents there. And Brad, you can add to it anything.
I think we're going to do this. Get the authorization to be prepared for this next meeting.
If council approves to. And by the way, we will do it with the new software. We will do it in-house with the new software that EMS is utilizing. So we won't have to go to a third party. It'll all be done in-house. Any issues that come up with it will be resolved right here between council, myself, and obviously our attorney. If council approves it, Brad will come back to us in the future with various steps that we need to make in order to make it work.
Now this, we can do this only on houses?
We will get more into it, but it's fire calls and homes.
Well, homes, businesses, any place, I'm sure.
Well, what he's saying is vehicle crashes.
The one that crashes, you spend hours out there sweeping up the glass and stuff and cleaning it up.
Yeah. Which is the bulk of our calls. That's our support. We do anyway.
Very small, very few home fires. Like I said, it's not going to be a return on investment, so to speak, but it will help offset some of the cost.
Do I have a motion to allow Todd to proceed with first party bill?
Yes.
I'm making a motion.
And a motion. Second. Any other discussion? Tonight, hearing none, call for a vote. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
I don't have the ordinance for you next meeting.
Okay. Next on agenda is a budget work session. Setting that day.
Yes. The last couple of budget work sessions we had, we've all been kind of in a hurry to move forward. But I need 2 or 3 hours of cancel in order to bring each of you up to speed where you need to be at. So if you've got any suggested dates, Bob has got a calendar ready to look at. So
so your department heads have to have their stuff in by 15th. Next week.
15th, that's correct. Anything submitted after the 15th will come last up. So most of them have already submitted.
Okay, you need a week after that or 2 weeks?
I don't need but an hour after that. Most of them have already submitted.
Okay. All
right. I thought you said 2 or 3 hours.
I need 2 or 3 hours with y'all.
Oh, okay.
I'm talking about after the 15th, I'll be fully prepared on the 16th to proceed.
Okay. You want to do that all in one time or you want to split it into 2 sessions?
It's up to y'all.
We used to have take a Saturday morning and have a meeting like that and do it. Get it all done in one week.
It's up to y'all, it's fine with me.
When do you want it on Saturday? How would take it? After the 15th.
What dates, Robin, we got?
So we got 26th.
19th.
Yeah,
19th,
26th.
What's that?
April 19th. 26th is Easter.
The 19th.
Is that? April 2nd?
2nd works good for me.
6 a.m.?
I don't know why you want to wait so late.
Just because I didn't think they'd get out of bed.
I won't be here April 2nd.
I have no problem with creating a budget for you, but I want to be sure that...
What night did we meet the other time?
Tuesday.
Maybe we could go back and try Tuesday.
Yeah, but nobody wants to spend three months on Tuesday, then I will.
We can get it done.
Tuesday, 22nd.
22nd.
22nd of March.
So you good?
Is that a good one? That'll work.
22nd.
$5,000?
$5,000. Matter of fact, you can start it as early as you want to, like, you know, anytime.
You can start it at $5,000. I'm just gonna be here if I'm gonna be nice.
I'll get here as quick as I can.
So I'm here at 5:00 in the evening on...
That's your miracle meeting.
Twenty-second.
I want you a little bit later, so I gotta work at like 6:30, but I won't, I mean, I have to take a vacation today, I'll take it. I need to waste my vacation, but I'll take a vacation today, that's what everybody wants.
It's for the town, it's for the team.
Don't you and I gotta talk about it?
Jerry?
Five PM.
I'm here at 5 PM. Look, it's hard to schedule a time where I can get 100% attendance. If you can't make it, you know, I'll keep you updated.
We'll set that for next meeting or meeting.
Yeah, the birds will be tweeting them in.
I'm just wondering if I can set that.
Very big tweet.
Oh, one more thing. You've got in front of you the comprehensive plan. It is only a draft. There's some more work we have to go to it. However, what's in there, the reading is very accurate. Don't pay attention to anything else. But read through it, look through it. The Planning Commission has approved it and recommended to go to council. But please bring it back at next meeting because you will get another one. That's not the final draft. You will get a different one. So, but and then we'll depending on if there's any changes, the council's got it, we'll go to add in May or June for public hearing.
I'd like to thank Robin and Todd for helping me to reinstitute a Youth and Government Day for seniors at Tazewell High School. They're going to be here at the town hall on April 5th, spending most of the day here with different departments of the town. That's something we did for 30 years when I was at the high school, but somewhere in the last 2 years it got dropped. It's back. Thank you, Robin.
On the, I know everybody's paying their taxes, property taxes, and motor vehicle taxes. The only thing I'm asking about is motor vehicle taxes.
Okay.
What, can you explain to me about why we have to pay double tax to the county and
I'll be more than happy to add some comment on that, and I've had it come up in my career a number of times. Obviously, the county has a personal property tax, a real estate tax. Some of those things, if those funds go to toward or the library, 911, it dispatches for us after hours. Social services go toward all the citizens of the town. There's a multitude of things that those tax dollars go toward. The town implements a personal property tax, obviously, to support everything that we do for the community, and it's also obviously by state charter that we have the ability to do that. I don't know if that answers your question or not.
Yeah, I mean,
you can't, but the city hall.
Okay.
By same token, David, okay, and they have until the end of this month. For elderly that is over 65 and meets a certain criteria, we have that exemption. So
we do handle it.
Okay.
That's what we have. I think it's all good.
No, we've got that voted on, and we have that exemption. And it's actually in their newsletter that went out on the front page.
Captain Fox, does that answer?
That's
just what, I'm not saying it's right or wrong, but that's just some of the things that those past dollars do go to the county level. Just some of them.
If there's nothing else brought before the council, we will recess until March 22nd at 5:00.